My name is Nat, and I'm a guitarist and oud player, and I live in Portland, Oregon. And I've been working as a musician for over 20 years, performing and continuing to learn, working on several different kinds of music, different traditions from around the world included. And I also play in and manage a group that combines several of those traditions and tours around the States and a little bit overseas. But I was feeling like I had hit the plateau that, you know, we've all musicians have experienced that. And there were the same problems that I had had for years were still there. And even though I was putting in the time, and discipline was not a problem, and I had no problem putting in the time and doing tedious work and playing slowly, but there were things that really felt like they should be better. You know, a lot of, probably every musician has that feeling from time to time. This should be better by now, as hard as I'm working on it. I've had the good fortune to study with a lot of the top musicians in the kind of music that I play. But I couldn't find anybody that could help me break through those plateaus. It's difficult for master musicians who don't remember going through the process to explain it. So for me, one of the most productive things about this this work with Gregg on the details of what to do when obstacles come up was when I come back to the practice room the next day, and there is such a clarity about where to pick up, where I'd left off, and what the most productive thing to be continuing with. And in fact, I mean, to the point that I actually cut back on my practice time at some point, and I checked in with him about that just to run it by him. I felt confident about the decision because it suddenly seemed so clear when it was just kind of, I was just repeating, and it was not in a productive way, and I was quite likely running the risk of reinforcing something that I may have just worked hard to undo. So after some repetitions of applying contextual interference exercises that matched those obstacles, there was the feeling of your technique cooperating with you, and the freedom to think, you know, some of your attention has been opened up to think about dynamics and tone. And so, of course, it just feels so much better. It feels so much more musical and expressive. If all of your attention is going to just kind of struggling to make it, you know, that never feels good. And that's where a lot of musicians and students live, you know, a lot of the time. The plateau makes up a lot of our lives as musicians. But when you break through the plateau, it feels so good that it keeps you going through anyway. But when you realize that there are these really specific tools, really, really, really specific tools to just cross things off the list, that it really, really looks different. And yeah, it's hard to explain without sounding vague myself, because it's you know, it's it really surprised me. It surprised me how quickly it takes effect. It's interesting, I think, because there's such specific approaches that can be applied to any passage, any technique, any movement in your technique. That's a big part of why it can just be applied right away, and they become tools that you will use for the rest of your life. It was life altering for me. That's something I was looking for years.